And I said, you know what, it's not really today about a demonstration or about a protest, because inside me today and all the build up to this and everything I saw happen online when people were talking about it felt more like a thing of thanksgiving for the friendships, for the solidarity, for more than anything, for what we each found inside ourselves through this fight. So, as old as it sounds, perhaps there's a little thanksgiving for fracking, that it had one good side, and that was to make us all stand together against it. And we have done amazing work, and I think that the biggest round of applause for the entire day should happen for ourselves, for the work we've put in, the fact that we started as nothing, and we're here today solely on one subject, and we made it to over 2,000 people today at our peak. So much of your time, your effort and your money. We also raised well over £500 just amongst us, those who can least be expected to keep on giving. But you did that as well today, so thank you. But it's also what you do in your communities when you go home to them and you gather together and you have your meetings and you do film showings and you arrange to object to planning and you keep on top of that. And for the people who've been with us from the start and never abandoned us, the Green Party, Friends of the Earth, who supported us every step of the way, I have huge gratitude. I'm not going to steal too much time, and if you can make it on the night, thank you very much. It is what it is, and it's not about being Tina, it's about me representing what an activist is, what's done to an activist to stop us doing this. So why are they taking me to court, and why do I have to spend 14 nights in prison? And this is simply because they think that if they do that to me, that it will scare you. Stupid, because all it does, I think, because if any one of us had to go to prison, we would all stand with whoever that was, because we are a solid and united movement. Of course there are ups and downs. We have our moments. I have to admit, today didn't come together with the finest of ease, but it came together. At one point in the week, we were panicking a bit because a few things weren't quite going according to logistical plan. And I'm like, you know what? The movement's coming. So whatever else happens is the icing on the cake, because we've already got us. Anyway, I'm only here really to do three things. The first one is to introduce a video. And I am, when it's Emma Thompson, who did some baking in a field with bananas once. And she asked me, what do you think is important for me to focus on? And I said, you know what, there are people who rarely make it to the stage, and that's the protectors of the camps. And I wanted her message to mention what we call them quite often, which is the investor removal team. Because it's through their actions that we have crippled this industry financially. That every time they blockade, whenever they blockade and set up a camp and look very unfriendly, they're very good at that to the crackers. That's when you read in the investor press, UK public shale gas opposition deters investors. So our investor removal teams in the field, thank you to you, to everybody who puts up with the cats and endures so much. So next up is Emma Thompson's video in solidarity with the entire movement and especially the investor removal teams. Also, after that, we're going to have a little moment of solidarity for those people in Standing Rock enduring such harsh conditions. And then the only thing I insisted I wanted to do today, which was to have the privilege of introducing John Ashton, who means so much to our movement. But in the meantime, this is the Emma Thompson video, which we haven't tested because we're not that organized, and we're going to see if this works.
Oh, this is Emma Thompson in London calling the investor removal team. All power to you on this national anti-fracking march. I wish I was there. I'm sorry, I'm in London doing my day job, which is why I look like I've just been released into the community. I mean, I'd rather be being sprayed with shit in a field in Lancashire, but I'm with you in spirit. I thank you so much, each and every one of you, for what you have endured and are enduring to make sure that this utterly ridiculous, utterly out of the question thing that people want to do to our country, to make sure it doesn't happen. I know we're separated by all sorts of things, but you're also standing with the Inuit in the Arctic against their fight to protect their land, and also with the Sandy Rock protesters in North Dakota. And what binds us is that we are fighting for a frack-free future, that went well, a frack-free future for our children and ourselves. It can't be allowed to happen, and it's fantastic what you're doing. I wish I was there. All power to your elbows. See you soon.
My sister Julie and I were so lucky when we did the bake-off in a field. We got a call from Greenpeace saying, do you fancy doing something a little bit dodgy in that fracking field you took before? We thought, yes. So we went in and did a bake-off, and as she mentioned, the lava spring was all with poo. It was awful. But the day itself was brilliant. This now, I expect everybody here, because we're clued up, caring people working for the best intentions of ourselves, is aware that there are other people exactly like us over in North Dakota, currently being attacked with pepper spray, being brutally attacked by dogs and thrown into jail. You know, what we get away with, we need to hold on to, because as crap as our democracy is, it's that little bit of democracy we've got left, and we need to fight it to the death to keep hold of it. What's happening in North Dakota is unimaginable. Here is a, you know, we are more densely populated, but we will encounter, like we did at Barton Moss, and like we did at Upton and Halls Hill, we will encounter police in bad situations. When I was putting together the photographs in this little bit, I'd also just finished putting the photos together for the day, and it surprised me. I was getting pictures of us, you know, with our kids and actions and events, and they were beautiful images. And I went to Dakota, and there was moms with their kids, and the same. And it was the same, and you could not tell where they ended and we began. Apart from that, they had way better headdress, and they had horses. We don't have them. So I would say that the Dakota for Standing Rock, they sent across a message that unfortunately was so full of noisy wind and poorly downloaded that it didn't work. But they sent their solidarity to us, and they asked through Josh Box that we stand strong, because we are in a unique position. Fracking is not happening in the UK. We aren't stopping it. We're not letting it get started. That's the position here. Because if it gets started, they get the laws on their side, the trade agreements on their side, and then they get to drag us through court, which is why I won't give in on my court case, because they think they can cripple us with law and costs, and that will not break us, nothing will. So, solidarity with Standing Rock. The games, I sit still for a bit in the march and just watch people walk past, and ended up getting swallowed up in hugs and warmth and solidarity. And I can't tell you how much this all means to me.